Hello students. So in today's class we are going to discuss about strings in Python. Already we have discussed a lot regarding the strings concept. So when do we call a particular character or a number belongs to a string? So when we enclose any characters or any numbers, or if it is a special symbol even, so whatever you enclose within a single quotes or a double quotes, that will be represented as a string, right? So that is what we are going to discuss now. So we are going to discuss many examples related to this. So if you consider in this example, print of enter your name, they have given a name equal to input function. So this input function helps you to fetch input from the user that will be assigned to the name variable, and in turn this name variable is being retrieved over here, and we are concatenating along with the hello string. So if you do so, what will happen? Enter your name will be displayed here, and now we are accessing the input from the user as Raji. Now hello Raji will be printed together. If you need space in between both the strings hello Raji, what you have to do here is you have to provide a space before you make use of the double quotes, before you make use of the closing quotes. So then space will be provided. So as we have discussed, the sequence of characters inside a string can consist of a letter or a number or any special characters, or even a backslash can also be enclosed to within the single quotes or double quotes to consider as a string. And in Python, both the single quotes as well as the double quotes will be treated in the same manner, except the triple quotes, because we make use of the triple quotes for a completely different purpose, or if you want to span multiple lines of statements, at that point of time you will make use of the triple quotes. So let us see some examples related to all these stuffs. And if you look at here, fruits equal to mango, apples and grapes, they have enclosed within double quotes. And what we are doing here is, usually when we want to assign any values to a variable, for example a equal to 5, if you are going to give 5 is an integer value which you are assigning to the variable a, sometimes even you can assign a floating point value also to the variable a, right? In the same manner you can assign the string to the particular variable. See, that is what they have done here. Fruits equal to mango, apples and grapes, they have assigned or declared to the fruits variable. Similarly, the same thing they have done here. A is a variable, and for that variable they have assigned good morning. So this good morning is a string that has been assigned to the variable A, and if you want to display the output, if you just give the variable A, good morning will be printed. The same has been done with the hello world. So here they have used the double quotes, here they have used the single quotes. So both single quotes and double quotes will work in the same way in Python, will be treated as the same. Now let us see some different examples. Now in case if you want to insert or if you want to specifically indicate a particular word with a single quote or a double quote, or whether you, sometimes you, we may wish to highlight some particular words right in between the sentence, to do that what we have to do here is we have to make use of the backslash symbol. So by using the backslash symbol, we can allocate or we can highlight the text in between the sentence. So to do this, A equal to write article on AI, here to assign the quotes for AI, both the double quotes, before the double quotes you have to insert the backslash character. So once you insert the backslash character, this quotes will be assigned over here. And similarly, if you try to print the statement, print of A, if you give, for this entire sentence they have used the double quotes. So what happens here, the starting double quotes and the ending one, both these double quotes belong to the entire sentence, whereas this double quotes which has been given along with backslash belong to this particular word AI alone. So this is how it gets printed. In the same way they have done for the next example. Here they are trying to give an apostrophe for the name Mira. So to do this also, we have to make use of the backslash along with the apostrophe. So this is how you have to work on this. And now we will discuss about empty string. So what do you mean by an empty string? Which is without any characters. So if you give a single quotes or a double quotes without any characters in between, characters in the sense it can be a number or it can be a string or it can be any special symbols even. So if you're not going to specify any values in between the quotes, that represents an empty string, which is the length of the string is zero. So see here, str equal to double quotes they have given, but we have not provided any characters within the quotes. So what will happen? A blank space will be printed. Similarly, here they have given a single quota. So even in this single quote, what they have done, they have not provided any characters. So an empty space will be printed. As I have told you, single quotes and double quotes will be both treated in the same way in Python. So this is how an empty string will work. And now let us discuss about this other strings. How to split a string into two lines. So, or how to print in the next line. So if you see in this example, what they have done here is, you know, instead of, sometimes you will feel like instead of typing everything in a same line, we will feel like typing in the next lines, right? So to do that, here they have used the double quotes. Here is a line along with backslash. By using the backslash, even if you type in the next line, the entire sentence will be printed in the same line in your output. So to do this, you have to make use of the backslash symbol. And now this backslash is also called as an escape sequence. So this backslash is also called as an escape sequence. And if you wish to display the output in the next line, what you have to do here is you have to use this escape sequence along with the n. So the slash n represents a new line. So new line means if you want to display the sentence in the next lines, at that point of time, you have to make use of this backslash n. So that represents a new line symbol. So if you see in this example, c equal to we are Indians slash n they have provided, and we love our country. So what will happen here? We are Indians will be displayed in the first line, and after the slash n, whatever sentence you have, that will be displayed in the next line. So for this particular purpose, we make use of this slash n symbol, which is the escape sequence. Or so slash represents the escape sequence, and slash n you will call it as the new line symbol. And even you can make use of this backslash, which is the escape sequence, along with T. So T represents the tab space. So that is the horizontal space. And I have told you already, in Python, a tab space will provide four default spaces. So four default spaces means what will happen? Four horizontal spaces will be provided. So if you look at this example, A1 equal to name slash T class they have given. So between the name and the class, four spaces will be allocated. See here, output simultaneously name followed by four spaces has been allocated, and then this class word will be printed, and followed by that again slash T section. So to provide horizontal space, we make use of slash T. And now even for A2, Ria slash T, 11 slash T, B they have given. So what will happen? Horizontal spaces will be provided. So for these purposes, we make use of this backslash or the escape sequences. And if you look at the escape sequence, actually it is a non-printable character. So non-printable character, it can also called as non-printable character, which is you will use this backslash along with the other symbols to treat as white space characters. So let us see some different symbols, what they have given, for what purpose they are used for. So if you look at slash new line, that is a slash in to display sentences in the next line, we make use of the slash in symbol. And this slash single quote, if you give, an apostrophe will be placed in between the words, or in between the string, which we have already discussed. And similarly, slash double quotes, or slash a bell or alert, and then for to give the backspace or a new line, then horizontal tab, vertical tab, or to provide a space in between. So for each and every new line symbols or contain escape sequences consist of different purposes, is used for different purposes. And if you look at this example, now we are going to discuss about multi-line strings. So multi-line strings means, I have told you, we will make use of for a completely different purpose. You don't have to use escape sequence in between when you come across the multi-line strings. See here. So when you make use of a single quote or a double quote, you have to make use of the escape sequences in between if you want to provide an apostrophe, or else to highlight the text with a single quotes or with a double quotes. So you have to use the escape sequences when you are working with single quotes or double quotes. But when you work with the triple quotes, that is the multi-line strings, you don't have to use any escape sequences. So that is one main advantage of the multi-line strings. So if you look at this example over here, see, print of Deep said, what's your job profile? So what's your job profile? If you see here, initially they have given triple quotes. So triple quotes can be done with the single quote or the double quotes. So here they have used the single quote as a triple quote. So this triple quote is completely for this entire sentence. So Deep said, what's your job profile? So in between, they have used the double quotes to highlight this, what's your job profile. For this, they have not used the escape sequences. Can you see here? So they have, even for this apostrophe, they have not used the escape sequences. That is a backslash. So backslash along with quotes, they have not used, because we have enclosed everything in the triple quotes. So it is not necessary to use escape sequences in between when we are working with triple quotes. So that is the difference between single and double quotes and the triple quotes. Got it? So what will happen? It gets displayed as such, whatever you give within the triple quotes. Similarly, see here, they have used the double quotes here. The overall sentence string has been enclosed within double quotes. And Deep asked, so when we are using double quotes, what we have to do? In case if you're highlighting the sentence in between, you have to include the escape sequence. So that is the backslash followed by quotes and backslash followed by quotes to highlight over here. So this is how we have to work with. Similarly, if you look at here, they have used a single quote for the entire string and they have used escape sequences in between. But see here, in this example, what they have done to display the sentence in the next line, what they have done here is they have used the slash and symbol, which is the new line. So new line symbol, I have told you, to display the sentence in the next line, we can make use of the new line character. So got it. So this is the difference between single quotes and double quotes as well as the triple quotes. So in the next class, we will discuss about the other examples and a few more concepts related to string. Thank you, children.